Do you know that the National University of Singapore's Master in Business Analytics has an industry partnership with over 100 such companies? As well as that, they are offering 100% internship opportunities after their capstone project. Intriguing, interesting, and wonderful, right? So welcome back to this channel. Today we'll be talking all about National University of Singapore, or NUS, MSB, that is Master in Business Analytics program. This is Ananya, your MSBA expert, and today we'll be dissecting this program from numerous perspectives, ranging from fees, curriculum, careers and employment, and whether this would be the right fit for you or not. So without any further ado, let's dive straight into it. The NUS University is located in Singapore, as its name also suggests. National University of Singapore had been merged with Nanyang University and founded in 1980. This particular university has its own BAC, Business Analytics Center, which is offering you a master's in business analytics, which deals with the entire world of data, business, and how this amalgamates to form various decisions in the current scenario. Offered in Singapore for both local and overseas students, this particular program can be taken either 13-month full-time or 2-year part-time course. However, this is an integrated course, which is a balance of experiential learning and theoretical learning, wherein you'll be learning all the theories and also have the option to apply it through various programs held, especially the capstone project, which we'll discuss in the coming part of the video. Now, if you're discussing about who this program really is for, so if you're coming from the IT or digital sector or finance or economic sector or other social science related fields, you can use your current skills and also kickstart your career in this rather exciting world of data and business analytics, which is more than just numbers as you might think for it right now. Offered in Singapore, this is a global hub for all the overseas students, wherein you'll have the opportunity to explore throughout Asia. Let's talk about the curriculum for this particular course. So you need to take 8 modules, that is 5 core courses and 3 electives. But this particular program is not just all about theories. You will be learning a lot of theories, wherein you will be amalgamating the theories of data, that is through operation research, and also learning about big data analytics and other sub-subjects. So you will be combining this data and you will be learning it while you'll apply it in the real world setting through various seminars and capstone projects and internship opportunities. Talking about the capstone, so this is a year long entire project wherein 3 to 6 months would be completely dedicated to the project, and you'll also have capstone classes and various seminars which will teach you all about this interesting world of analytics. Wondering if you really fit into this program? Well, the program is definitely competitive, but there is not just one single criteria that you check mark. So if you have chance, you should really apply for it. Why not? So number one is your bachelor's degree. So this should be coming from a recognized institution and preferably in the field of IT and other digital fields, and also business and economics and other related fields here also. But if you come from other backgrounds and you can show them a good skill set, well, you're welcome. Next up is relevant work experience. So if you're not from this particular realm, you can showcase a 2-year working experience, which would make it established that you are well aware of all the skills required or the preliminary qualification required to step into this world. Next up, your quantitative GMAT or GRE scores. So for international students, you are required to submit these scores for sure. But if you have completed your bachelor's from a recognized local university in Singapore, like the NUS or NTU, well, you might just skip this part as well. Next up definitely is your strong foundation in mathematics. So you have to prove that you have a strong base and a strong foundation in mathematics. Followed by that, you pay $200 non-refundable admission fees and also $4,000 if you secure your spot. So for locking your seat, you need to hand in $4,000. So we are starting with the application process. Number one, you need to start your application from the official website. So you go to the website and start your application and start filling the details. Next up is your resume or CV. So this particular document needs to have all your relevant experiences, your education, any merits that you have, awards and achievements, and all the things that you would really like to boast of in person as well. Next up, your official identification documents. You need to hand in some official identification document or maybe your passport to prove your identity. Next up, your academic qualifications, so all the degree scores, the transcripts and the mark sheets, all of these need to be handed to prove that you've completed your bachelor's as expected in the prerequisites. Next is your GMAT or GRE score, so you self-report these scores on the portal, followed by two referee reports. So you need to submit two referee reports for sure. Now these reports can come from either your academic supervisor, or it could be your previous or current employer, or it could also be any client that you have worked with and can provide some real-time experience of you working with them as well. Next up is your financial documents. So you need to prove your financial ability or capability to be paying for your tuition fees. Next is your personal statement. So you will be answering three questions that is required from you. You can either do it in writing or you can make a video of maximum 3 minutes answering these particular questions. With this, we sum up all the entire process that is required to be stepping into this elite cohort of students at NUS MSBA program. Next up, we talk about the financial aspect, which is really important for determining your return on investment. So as an international student, you will be submitting somewhere around $65,000 as the total fees. But if you are a graduate from NUS, you get to pay $55,000. That is a 15% rebate. And also if you are Singaporean or a permanent resident there, you get to pay $58,000. While this might sound steep, you have numerous options of scholarships listed. So wherever you come from and whatever your capability and ability is, you would like to scroll through the list and find out where you really fit in and go to the website and apply for these scholarships. You might get into one. Well, the good news in the end, or the cherry on the top of the cake, is that your career and employment. So the good news is that 100% of the previous class was employed within 6 months of their graduation, landing in around $92,000 of approximate average starting salary, which is a very good number. These students are working in finance the most, then technology, then consulting and other functional roles in the multinational companies, which you're well acquainted with for sure. Well, this made me thinking, why just NUS? Imperial could be the right fit for me as well. So if you want to know about Imperial's Master in Business Analytics program, you would like to watch our Imperial MSBA review as well. Well, we have also a long list of other MSBA programs which come in top 10 of QS World Ranking. So glance through and come to decide in the end whether this particular program in comparison to others would be in your checklist or not. Well, this sums up our entire review or overview of NUS MSBA program, and whether it would be the right fit for you or not, that is for you to decide. This is Ananya signing off. See you later.